We're broadcasting live from Newsom Stadium in Nashville, home of the Lycans and the world capital of country music.
I just love country music, Rim. Always some sweet song about a man's family or his dog.
Or how he had sex with all of them. Where's my smokes?
Remember, in the MFL, we encourage you to play with your food. He's probably lining up against you. The Cardinal Sins go up against the Nashville Lycans. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say.
Hey, man, nobody can touch me with an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about, pal?
Welcome to MFL Sunday School, where the good playbook teaches it's an eye for no reason, a tooth for an eight ball, and a limb for just looking at me the wrong way. MFL Game Day is on the air. Grim Blitzrow, my partner's Bricks and Bricks Jr. Hey, man, these guys flat out want to kill each other today.
Yeah, these are the kind of games families come out to see. It's good for the sport.
You know what I like about this home team is 90% of them were born criminally insane. You can't teach that. And it's first and 10. That pass play nets them 7 yards.
Oh, no. I got the hiccups again. What are you supposed to do to get rid of them again?
You stick it in the plastic bag, say the alphabet backwards while you set yourself on fire and jump out the window. It ought to stop them.
Great play by the defense. It's not too often a quarterback gets rejected.
That's why that's the position I originally tried out for. I want to know what it's like for other people to accept you.
Now that went from a joke to making me feel feelings. Stop it. This isn't a play. And he breaks away. Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. First and 2. And here comes the extra point attempt. Straight through the uprights. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutant meat.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. And it's first and 10. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
And he picks up 8 yards on a strong run. Third down and, well, good luck. Footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole.
Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. He boomed that one. Let's see if he's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. First and 10. 40, second and 8 to go. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's going to have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit.
Too fast, dude. I'm the greatest. The greatest, I tell you.
Third and 2. Hit, the quarterback goes down. And out comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. Nice punt. Should move him back nicely. Nice catch, and he turns on the end, and he just wrestles away from that tackle.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made into dice, Grim. It'll be fun to gamble with my own teeth!
And he shuffled his feet so well on that play, he should go to lost wages and deal cards. First down! And it's first and 10. That ball just sliced through the defense like butter.
I wish defenses were made out of butter.
Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day, because he's the one who just got wiped out.
I'm going to say maybe 3 yards, but a tough 3 yards. Second down and 7. That's gotta hurt. Man, those mutant traps will kill you faster than one of Brick's farts. And it's first and 10. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. Oh, that gets me every time. Like a jack in the box, Bricks. You never know when one of those hot potatoes is gonna blow. You just crap your pants, Junior. Third and 2.
Nerd fan base to bring him into the game.
There's no reason to go for it here, but they do anyway. He dropped it. If he does that again, they'll drop him. And this game is up for grabs. And it's first and 10. I just may be in commentary, but I thought you were supposed to throw the ball forward.
Yeah, you're right. You should.
Second down and 10. he just got crushed. Third down, and the punter is warming up. Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. And he put all of his foot into that one. And he snags the punt and looks for open field.
I had a donkey.
Oh, look at this guy break tackles. And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. And it's first and ten. Some good old-fashioned downhill running as he picks up 9 yards on the play. And that'll bring up second and one. And then it's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
And it's first and ten. Loves punishing the defenders. That's a first down. And it's first and ten. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It's good. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chip wearing a wig.
And it's first and ten. A lot of guys talk about stepping up their game, Bricks. He just stepped up and blew up. He's got a lot of guts, doesn't he? And you can see the grounds crew cleaning him up now. Hot potato gets him every time. And it's first and ten. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
Second down in a very lot. Down and never gonna happen. Oh man, I love this dirty trick. The quarterback unleashes a rocket. Oh, what a brutal hit. And it's first and ten. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done! Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. This guy couldn't hit the side of a fallout shelter. We When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
Face. I want to see if he's crying.
Yeah, man, he's gonna hit him now. You know what
happened? Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. And it's first and 10. And that catch will give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
Offense calls a timeout. This is why you save your timeouts, so you can use them in the 2-minute warning.
Now I get it. Makes sense, Grim.
First and 8 to go. And he pounds the ball into the defense, picking up 7. Bring up 2nd and 1. He took a beast boost injection and he rumbles into the end zone for the score.
I hope he's not gonna dance now. Yeah, that's not fair. Someone should call a penalty on this man.
Second down and long, and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. And look at that ref run. He makes it out of bounds to survive another play. Second down and offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. Call that about a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem.
The timeout is called by the quarterback. They have 1 left. The offense changes the pace by going into a hurry up.
Does that mean the defense gets into a hurry up too?
And that's a pick. And now the quarterback is cursing the... Oh, nice hit. And it's 1st and 10. And the QB might as well just bury himself now because this guy... Nice run for 5 yards. First time out under 2 minutes. The chess game has begun.
It's like chess, only you can kill people.
2nd down and 5. Man, oh man, he hit that line the way your wife hits the all-you-can-eat buffet at Crab Apple Trees, Bricks.
You're telling me.
The QB saves some clock by calling a timeout. They have 1 left. It's first and 10. Oh, nice hit. That's the way you do it. Let him have it and then take it away. Second down and 10. Game should be their bread and butter. A gain of 8 right there.
Hey, anyone seen that Korean kid yet with my barbecue?
Last time I ordered Korean, I got Kim Jong-il.
And that's the last time out. They can't stop the clock anymore.
Can any of us really stop the clock, Rim? I mean, when it comes right down to it, are we not all united by the constant reminder of our own mortality? Of death's constant, relentless advance? If only it was as easy as telling them time out to stop our own clock.
The second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsanto Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. It's the start of the third quarter, and we are set to go, Bricks.
Oh, boy! Where are we going, Grim? A carnival? Then I'm going to a striptease show. Where are we going?
Why don't you settle down? Just pet your rabbit, Lenny. Just pet your rabbit. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. Oh, with the brain scrambler. Of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick. It can be like a monkey trying to fuck a greased football. He gets away in a hurry.
Hey, no game, no. Man, I can't. Come on, get on out.
Third down and, well, good luck.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
Nice punt! Should move him back nicely. He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it.
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
And it's first and 10. That's a 6-yard gain on that catch. And that'll be second down and 4. Oh, what a sack there. I heard this guy likes to play with soft balls. He's going to play with crushed balls from here on out. Third down and long. It for 4 yards. You know, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. And he put all of his foot into that one, and he's got a chance for a good return here. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
Yeah, sounds like my offseason.
And it's first and 10. Huh? finishing hit. And it's first and 10. Second down and a lot.
First down! I've seen this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sinners then.
The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just guineas.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And it's first and 10. A good run for 5 yards.
Hey, didn't move the change of score, did it? How good can it be?
Second down and 5. At this rate, the QB's gonna have more interceptions than completions. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. And it's first and 10. Defense holds him to a 4-yard pickup there. The offense lost another quarterback on the previous play and have only 2 left before they have to forfeit.
Yeah, but on the bright side, Wynn, they save a ton of money by not having to pay those guys anymore. That's the funeral expenses, that is.
Second down and 6. Oh, great throw! Great catch! And that puts 6 points on the board!
The defense couldn't do anything to stop a throw that good, man!
You mean aside from bribing the ref, killing the quarterback, harassing playing some D?
Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
Straight through the uprights. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a bra in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
It's first and 10. Second down in a very lot. A big gain run on that. Third down and 9. And it's first and 10. That's a killer. It was right there, and then he dropped it.
Oh, scumbag is killing me in the fantasy league.
Second down and 10. If you don't hear it coming, it'll knock you right on your ass. It's called us. His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. Quarter three comes to an end, but this game is far from over and will be decided in the final quarter. First and 4. And the crowd goes wild. Touchdown! Touchdown! And they come to the line trying to tie this up with 2 points.
And if they don't, things are going to get weird and desperate on their sideline.
Hey, give them more credit. And he runs it in for an easy 2 points. The momentum in this game may be shifting.
Well, those are just my balls.
Hey, thanks for sharing, Briggs.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
First and 10. And he just used his beast boost dirty trick, and there's no way to stop him. And first down. And the running game opens up for them and allows the passing game to be more of a threat. Gotta keep him guessing. And it's first and 10.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
First and 8 to go. And into the end zone with a burst of speed.
And I think he's more of a downers guy than a speed freak, Trent. He's running from his feet, it's clear.
Should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. First and 10.
Oh my gosh! The defensive player looks like he's...
And the MFL keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 98.8. The greatest hits of all time.
Huh? Did you just say greatest hits? Where?
First down and 1. Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey.
Actually, he does have some turkey skin wrapping on his backside from that bad burn he had last year.
And they line up for the extra point. home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And it's first and 10.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not your own.
And it's first and 10. That's how you run the football. A pickup of 7 on the play.
Grim, why is it that more mentally disturbed clowns don't play football? They'd be good.
You know, they're all in politics, apparently. Well, it looks like he wanted to run before he caught it. You gotta keep your eye on the ball.
Come on, you dirtbag. You gotta make that catch.
Third down and 3. It's 2-yard run before he stopped. The offense is lining up to go for it on fourth down, and the defense is looking for a stop or a death. Either will work, but they prefer the kill. One potato, two potato, three potato, four. The defense just blew up a player who thought he was going to score. Oh, that hot potato dirty trick gets him every time. First down and 9. Oh, big catch! Big run! Big touchdown!
And big deal. Missed a beat for Brady, grabbing a ball and didn't fall down.
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. First and 10. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
Third down, and the punter is warming up. Oh, and the quarterback threads the needle for a first down. And it's first and 10. That's a 4-yard gain. They quickly call a timeout, hoping to save some time for their offense. Second down and 6. And the quarterback finds his man for the first down. The defense is leaving the team with just one timeout. so they better bring the ball back gift wrapped.
Is it time for a ribbon or a ball, Grim?
Maybe if they use their last timeout. The defense better watch out. The quarterback just threw a murder ball.
I love them.
Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
You have got to be kidding me. My sister could have made that kick. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. That's the last timeout. It's score or die from here out. And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players. And he snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get something going here. And it's first and 10. First down! He was not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. And that's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
First and 4. No, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole. All up here talking to you.
And the quarterback throws another pick. He should have eaten his Sleeties this morning. Pow! With the brain scrambler. And it's first and 10. A big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that. The Gnashville Lycans win at home, and fans here are liking what they're hearing.
Oh, that's kind of like a poem.
It was a decisive win. The home crowd is cheering and throwing up at the same time. Too much excitement and booze will do that to you, and the players are celebrating as they search for missing appendages. They left it all on the field today, or most of it anyway.
Boy, you're not kidding. The blood and gut-sucking Zamboni is coming out now. Hey, if anyone needs a liver transplant, there's a nice-looking one down on the 40-yard line.
And let's hear what the MVP has to say.
Oh, I can't wait to hear what the most valuable prickhead has to say. Blah, 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 you suck. You take my fantasy game last week, you douchebag.
Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the MicroHard Corporation. They get it right every up.